Hello, I'm Mel. I'm socialmediatraffic.com. How to create a GIF or GIF image using GIMP, demonstrated and narrated by James Sasek.
Hi, today we're going to do a video on how to create your own GIF or GIF, depending on what you want to call it, using the GIMP tool. So I'm going to assume you know a little bit about GIMP already here. I just want to kind of show you some of the tips and tricks that I've used and learned to take care of some of these. So the first thing that you need, obviously we're creating a motion video here, so you're going to need to collect all of the images that you want. So you can capture them from a movie, or maybe you've set something up where you're taking pictures very fast on a tripod. Whatever the case is, you'll want to get those all collected, and then you'll want to have them in layers in order, going one right on top of each other. So I have one already created here that will give you a pretty good example. So just real quick, I'll show you what the end product looks like here. And I will have a link to this in the comments as well. So you can see, really all we're trying to do is move this one section right in the middle of this guy's face. So what we've done here, one of the things you need to consider with GIFs is really about size. So what we've done here is we've actually taken, you can see, we've taken and we've added an alpha layer, and you can do that just by right clicking and do add alpha layer, and then you can do that under the layer tools as well. But we've added the alpha layer. You may or may not need to do this depending on where you've got your images, but this allows us to do transparency. So you can see we've actually deleted these top layers, which is fine because we're overlaying now on top of the background image. So you can see when I show the background image, these are all overlaying right on top of it here. And when I remove it, you can see all we have are the guy's face moving. And then if you scroll up a little bit more, you can actually start to see where his arm starts to move up as well. So I've deleted as much as I possibly can. This is something that you'll want to consider. You may not be able to do it with your image if there's a lot of panning or that kind of thing. You may not be able to do that. One of the other tools that I use that's really handy is I have an image registration tool. And what I did is I went through, and for every single frame, I ran this at least once to the background image, and that allows allows the tool to go and outline everything and make sure that the backgrounds line up with each other. So there is a little camera jiggle in this as an example, but that's really helped there. So once you've gone through, we've put all our frames in, we added the alpha channels, and we've cropped everything. Okay. In order to view what we've done so far, you can actually go to filters and animation, and this should all be built in. And you hit playback, and it will actually open it for the full resolution of whatever you've put in there. And when you hit play, it's going to show you all of the entire thing. And you can step through and rewind if you need to. So it's looking pretty good at this point. So the next thing that I'm going to do is I need to make sure that my image mode for a GIF is in grayscale or indexed. So right now it's in indexed. This is pretty easy to do grayscale, but I want to show you when anything that's already in black and white is easy to do in grayscale. And if you click grayscale, it's just going to turn everything black and white. But I'm going to, when you go into indexed, something that you need to do, basically GIFs can only do 256 colors, and one of them is here, we do 255 because one of them is reserved for transparent. In order to make sure that this works okay, if you do this, it'll actually kind of posterize everything, and it's going to create 256 across the entire, for all of the images. So you may want to go through and do some removing of colors. You may want to edit every single one of the frames to a certain extent. I've certainly done that before. One of the things that you're going to do is that you're going to hit Generate Optimum Palette, and this is going to come up with the 255 most common colors. And then you'll want to make sure to reduce certain kinds of color bleeding. You'll want to do Floyd Steinberg. And what this does is it overlaps a little bit of the frames of the colors with each other when there's movement near it, and that will help make it look a little bit more natural and not so posterized. So I usually try it with normal, and then I'll convert it, and if it looks okay, I'll use it. And if it doesn't, I'll undo it and do some editing. So, for example, you may want to, if you're trying to reduce some of the colors, you may actually want to go through and posterize it yourself. You may want to go to the levels or the curves and start tweaking it to just kind of limit some of the colors. So it really depends on what you're working from. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to save it. And pretty much all you got to do is once you save it as a GIF here, you're going to want to make sure and choose Save as Animation, right? If it is an RGB and it's not indexed or grayscale, you're going to see another little thing that pops up here that asks you if you want to turn it to grayscale. So I would recommend to do it manually. I would not recommend to do it at this point. The last thing that you do is you have some options here. You can create a comment. You can tell if you want to loop it forever or once. Another thing that you can do is delay frames when they're unspecified. So one thing that you can see over here... One thing that you can see over here is that I have different timing for frames, and you can just edit that by clicking Edit Attributes and changing the frame milliseconds. So I have the first frame sitting for a second so that you can see it pause, and then I have 90 milliseconds for the rest of them for the most part. It's actually 88 because what I'm doing is I'm actually pulling every fourth frame from a video, and that 88 works out pretty okay. So you can actually force it to use the above, to use 88 milliseconds for every single one or only for any frame where it's unspecified. They're all going to be unspecified unless you put in parentheses some amount of milliseconds after it over here. So that's definitely something to consider. So once you save it, you'll be able to go and look at it. One thing you do want to consider is the size. I've got this at about 1.1 meg. Depending on where you're sharing it, usually 1 megabyte is about the max you can do. So for example, Tumblr, 1 megabyte is the max you can do. I know if you're sharing it on Imgur, it's 2 megabytes is the biggest GIF that you can have on there and have it still run. So it's definitely something that you want to consider in terms of size. Once you've cropped everything out, you may decide that you want to remove some frames, and you can just step through. So you can see, I may decide that, you know, I'll hide that frame and then go between these two. I may decide that that's good enough, and then you can delete out this frame. Another thing that you can do is you can just scale it. So you can go into image scaling, and you can scale down to a smaller size, and that'll obviously reduce the size.
Social media traffic. For tips and strategies, get free instant access. Go now to my website, imsocialmediatraffic.com.